Like Nothing from This World. Yes, Plan 9 from Outer Space, The Flying Saucer. The old Lindbergh kit now released under Polar Lights through the Cool Cats at Round 2 is back. We're going to get a cool look at it. We're going to build it up. This was the actual plastic model they used in the movie Plan 9 from Outer Space to simulate UFOs, where they were coming down and raising people from the dead to stop Earthlings from destroying the universe. And it's got some cool pictures of the movie. You can actually see this movie on YouTube. It is copyright free now, so you can actually go and watch the movie and enjoy it. Buy the model kit and build it up. Now, if you want to build it up just like this with the painted over everything in silver, that's how it would look in the movie. You also have the option of doing it with the cool alien inside in the clear dome, some jet engines. It comes with a cool base. Let's take a look at everything that's going to be in the box when you get your copy. We'll throw all the plastic out here. There are not a lot of parts. We got our alien. We got our optional jet engines. We got the bottom of our saucer. We got the top of our saucer. We have the stand in plastic. We'll take a look at all the parts real quick. This is going to be an absolutely fun review to put together. We've got our little side engines for spinners. We've got our cockpit in there. We've got the holes for the jet engines. If you decide to do a movie replica, you'll just need to get a little squirt of putty or super glue into each one of those to fill them in so when you paint. But that is a nice looking kit. You could even light this. There is enough room for a small coin cell battery inside. We've got the bottom of the saucer there with that cool pattern on it and the inside. So you could definitely light this thing. We've got the halves of our jet engines on either half. We've got our little alien dude. He'll get painted up. We've got our clear dome. Beautiful piece. And we've got our base, which has the cool imprint of North and South America on a globe. You can go ahead and paint that, or you can not paint it, detail it however you want. It looks awesome. Also in the box is a sweet cardboard display stand. Your stupid minds, stupid, stupid. We've got Vampira. She makes an appearance in the movie. Bela Lugosi is in the movie. It is an absolute corny, so bad it's good movie from Ed Wood from 1959. And this sweet waterside decal sheet that you can use on anything you like, movie poster, slogans, everything's on there, bumper stickers, I Heart Grave Robbers, and Your Stupid Minds, all on there for you. So, I'm going to wash the parts off with some simple green, and then we will be back for a sub-assembly show-off, which is literally going to take a couple seconds. Arriving at sub-assembly time takes at most 30 minutes, even if you have no idea what you're doing, which is usually what I am doing most of the time. I've got the two hull halves glued together. They make a very tight seam. Of course, use a quality glue, and you shouldn't have to do a lot of seam work. Maybe just sand that down if you choose, but who's going to care about it? We've got the engines on. Now, I'm not going to be making a perfect movie replica. I want to make it as if someone bought the Lindbergh kit way back in the day when it was new and a kid wanted to build up a cool alien saucer for his room for display. So I put the jet engines on it. We got Mr. Man here, Mr. Alien Man. He's going to go right in there when we're all done. He's going to get primed up. The globe base needs to get primed. This will be used as a paint stand for the saucer for now when we prime it and spray it. And just before we're all done, this will be stuck on its own and sprayed in contrasting color so it doesn't show up as well. I am going to go over and get this in some paint. We'll have you come along. It's not going to take long at all. And then we'll be back. out of paint, and I really couldn't be more impressed with this cheap can of Rust-Oleum chrome paint. I mean, holy cow. And that's just over a black coat of their primer, and then I shot it with the chrome, and we're gonna let that dry. I have tested it in some small areas, like on the support arm here, and it seems to stay soft a lot longer than their other paints. So I'm not gonna touch this for a full 24 hours. I've actually taken it out into the sun to start hardening. Once it hardened about an hour, then I took it out in the sun to warm it up and let it harden all the way off. I'm gonna take it back out there when this video is done. In the meantime, I'm gonna get a chance to hand paint Mr. Alien. So he's gonna look cool. He's gonna sit inside there when we're all done. And I'm also going to hand paint North America, South America, Antarctica, Greenland, and where it says Flying Saucer. So I'll leave the rest of the globe blue, and then I'll just hand paint that for some details. Now on this chrome finish, I will not be applying any clear, like I just said, in the painting section. It looks beautiful as it is, and you run the risk of some chromes not liking a clear coat, even if I use the Rust-Oleum clear. There's no reason to clear it. I think it would be bare metal anyways. This is a cool 50 spacecraft, so I think it would look really cool. I also taped the corners of the awesome stand, and I can't wait to get it all done and set it on there. Even though it's not an exact replica of the one in the movie, it's still awesome. It's still an alien ship, and that was used in Plan 9 from Outer Space. Just in case you ask in the comment section, what is the exact name, even though I put the exact name of the paint in the video, we'll show it again. Rust-Oleum Bright Coat. Make sure it says Bright Coat. Metallic finish on the back. There's your product number. Bright Coat Chrome. And that seems to work well. So I might be trying that on some other ones, since I do love that spray paint, the speed of a spray paint job. And boy, did that ever turn out nice. That looks real metallic. That's real easy to do. I mean, even the bottom where I put too much on and it ran a little bit, I shot it again after about 10 minutes and it took all the runs away for the most part. Still looks great, but that top, it allowed all those panel lines to come through, didn't cover up any rivets, didn't cover up any detail at all, and it looks awesome. It looks absolutely awesome. So I'm gonna work on that. Also, I have an idea. For the front of the jet engines, they don't have anything on them. They're just an open hole. I used a bunch of these stick-on pearls from Walmart. They're 97 cents. They come in packages. Just get them out of the craft section. Ask the people that work there. They're self-adhesive. They're a pearl color. What I'm gonna try to do is use some Tamiya clear paints over these on this plastic film, let it dry, and see if I can't peel off one the right size and stick it on the front of each engine, sort of like a Star Trek nacelle. So you can snag those at Walmart for 97 cents. Maybe they'll work, we'll find out. I also want to paint with clear paints the end of each one of these little things that makes the rocket spin, or whatever our imagination says it does. I'm going to try putting some clear paint on each one to see how it's going to look, see what it's look like. Same as up here. We'll put some clear paint on these little domes up here. It's completely up to what you want to do. And then once this is hardened off enough, I will paint the inside of the cockpit there. They've got little gauges molded in. They've got little buttons molded in and stuff. So I can even use some car gauges to put in there that look like little gauges he can read and stuff. Or, as you can see, the details nice enough on there that you can hand paint those as well and bring out some details. So I'm gonna get to work on the base and on the figure, and by then, within 24 hours, this should be dry. We'll take another look. Again, this is gonna be a super fun and quick build. I've got the saucer done to where I decided to take it. I've got the little blue covers on the front of the engines, or I'm gonna call them engines and not laser blasters. That's what I wanna call them. So those are there. What I did was I took those little pearl dots from Walmart, covered them in Tamiya clear blue, and then let them dry, and then peeled them off, and then just stuck them right to the front of those engines. And I think that looks really cool and adds quite a bit to the model, a little bit of color on the outside. I decided not to tint anything else, but I still am considering the edges of these little, I'm gonna call them motors, whatever they are. Maybe that's what makes the bottom of the saucer spin. Who knows? You can make up whatever story you want with a model like this, and that's what's fun. We've got Mr. Alien Man all painted up with his chair, his backpack, his chest, his little controller microphone, and his green head. And then I washed him a little bit with black just to bring out a little bit of detail on him and let him stand out. All he does is press in the center. I future floor polish the dome, did a little black around the rim, and we'll push that down, and that'll be held on with friction. The base is done, and I think I did a nice job on that. I highlighted North America, South America, Antarctica. I did a chrome ring around it. Greenland with a little bit of white snow and ice. Same with the areas of Canada and Alaska. So that looks great. How I colored those in was just using multiple gel markers. You can get these anywhere, any craft store. Gel markers, they're metallic finish and a white one. Just easy to use, not a problem at all. So all I have to do is go ahead and put everything together and we're done. The cockpit is also done. Just the floor paint is still drying, you can see it. But I just added a little bit of detail inside the cockpit that you'll see through the dome. Those gauges there are from the Gopher decal review that we did this week. You can find those on that review. Just look at the review before this one, and you'll see that they're on there. And those were just mixed and matched from inside. It doesn't matter what they say, because this is a spacecraft. So I kind of made them look goofy with the arrows pointing all different directions and used some of the air conditioning vents in there and everything to mix and mash it up. All I have left to do now is detach the saucer from the arm. The arm is going to get painted now the same color as the water, so it just comes out. We've got that nice blue tint, and then I will be attaching that, and we are all done. I didn't use any of the decals. I'm going to be saving those if I build the diorama. I want that movie poster and those other details. And on here, the way I'm doing this ship up, I didn't want to muddy it up with any decals or but. If you wanted to add those are pretty awesome, so you, of course, could have a lot of fun with it. When I come back, we'll have the final and see where I took the ship. A beautiful, easy, fun day, one day build in the workshop. Came out awesome, easy to build, fun to do it however you want. Whether you want to leave those engines on there or call them laser blasters or paint the tips or do whatever you want to them. Do what I did to them. It doesn't matter. This is fun. It's not supposed to be accurate or perfect or whatever. All it's supposed to be is fun and a good time. And I really liked it. I love the planet base. I love that they were used by Ed Wood and Plan 9 from Outer Space, and that the cool cats at Round 2 through Polar Lights made this. They made the fun box on it. They used the images from the movie. They give you some fun stories. When you get yours, read the manual, read the box. It's got some cool little puns and quips on it. It's really interesting, and it also builds into a very, very cool early plastic model UFO spaceship. You can build it exactly as the replica of the movie by painting the whole thing silver, or you can go my route. Build it as the kit when it first came out and do what you want with the little alien and his dome and the cockpit there and decorate things and leave the engines on, leave the engines off. Paint it however you want. Don't paint the base. Paint the base. Do whatever you like. Just make sure that you have fun, which is all the model hobby is about. You'll get this cool base. You'll get these gorgeous decals you can use with the model or something else. Definitely saving these. Don't forget about those. And you get the awesome sauce model that just comes out fantastical. There will be some more pictures at the end so we can see that nice chrome finish in better detail. I thank you for watching the workshop. As always, you fans drive the show with your wonderful comments, your likes, your shares, your thumbs up, your subscriptions. That means that you want to see more cool models come out of the workshop, and I'm happy to deliver. I will see all of you at the next review. And again, the main theme about model building is it's a hobby. Have fun with it. Link in the description where you can get yours. And we'll see you soon.